Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very happy to be here and to have the opportunity to tell you some results of our work. It is a part of a bigger monitoring program in Hungary. This small part is the investigation of the habitat selection of Eurasian woodcock during the spring migration period in Hungary. Woodcock is a popular and an important small game species all around Europe. In most countries, people hunt woodcock, and in most European countries, there are efforts to collect data about the wintering and also the breeding and migrating populations. Hungary is also making efforts to collect data. The country lies in the southern part of the breeding area of the species, but there are few breeding birds in Hungary, so, and they are not easy to find. And also there are wintering birds, but the majority of woodcock passing in Hungary is in spring and in autumn during their migration from their wintering sites to their breeding sites. To have basic, really basic knowledge about this migrating population and to establish decent regulation of hunting of woodcock in Hungary, a monitoring program started in 2009 with participating observers. The number of these observers is more than 900, and they are collecting data in spring and also in autumn. In spring, they use roding surveys, which is based on the specific behavior of the bird. It is a display behavior. I don't know if you are familiar with it, so I will tell some words about that. The male woodcock is performing a display flight over the woodland canopy and calling with a whistling and croaking sound to find and attract females to mate with him. And it is a short period during the migration. It lasts one half hour or less, or maybe less. And during that, the woodcock can be seen, can be detected, and can be counted. In Hungary, we use synchronized censuses, so all 900 points are used synchronously and at one single day during 12 weeks, so 12 times each spring and 12 times each autumn. The observation points where the observations are carried out were selected by the observers themselves, so they was not told where to go. They had to select the sites based on their former experiences about the habitat use of woodcock. And this situations offers an opportunity to evaluate this choice. So the choice of the observers, what did they choose? Which sites do they find the best to observe woodcock? And this is connected also to the habitat choice of the woodcock. So in this study, we investigated the habitat selection of the woodcock during the spring migration, and we tested whether the preceding designation of the observation points reflect enough knowledge about these preferences. These are the selected observation points. The number is less than 900 because these points are those who made all the observations, so they were able to collect from all years and all dates that were available for comparison. And we, And we we compared the environment of these points with the environment of randomly generated points. We used geographic information systems for that. Each observer had to report the correct designation of these points, so we know exactly where they are and where they are working with these birds. So we created buffers for these points to have knowledge about the environment of the observation points. And also for the random points, we did that. The radius of this buffer was selected by a former knowledge of the roading behavior of the woodcock, because radio telemetry studies showed that they are using for these display flights approximately 60 hectares. So the radius was made according to this. This was twice the radius of a 60 hectare circle. We used for the choice of observers, we used one method. Key squared test was used to test. Key squared test of independence was used with Bonferroni Z test for pairwise comparison. And for the choice of the birds, we used two methods. The first method was that correlation was made with the land cover types with the detections of woodcock for each land cover type. And the second method was that we had a basic idea that for woodcock, wood is especially important, but the amount of forests can be interesting, so we classified each buffer according to the forest cover rate. We did three categories: open, mid, and forested, and took 50 random samples of each category, and we compared them with one-way ANOVA. Let's see. This first graph shows the results of the observer choice. So these occurrence frequencies of land cover types are quite similar in the random points with white and also the observation points with black. However, the key square test showed significant difference between them, between them. And the Bonferroni Z test for pairwise comparison showed that there was difference in the case of broadleaf forests, mixed forests, and transitional woodland shrub. These types of land cover were used more often than it was available randomly, and the use of this continuous urban fabric, non-irrigated arable land, fruit trees and berry plantations and inland marshes were used in lower proportion by the observers. It is important to note that Hungary is a lowland, and the majority of the country is non-irrigated arable land, so it is available in most parts of the country. I forgot to mention that forests, which are thought to be important for woodcock, the rate of forests in the country is nearly 20%, but it is growing. Okay. Let's see the choice of the birds, which is a bit more complicated because it is not only depending on land cover, but in this case we only investigated this part of the choice. We found significant correlations between some elements and the woodcock detections, but these correlations were weak. So it is a really weak but existing correlation. Negative correlation in the case of discontinuous urban fabric, non-irrigated arable land, and weak but positive correlation with broadleaf forests. In the case of the second method, the forest cover categories, we found no significant differences among the forest cover rate categories. So we have seen that the choice of the
point.
So the choice of the point was not resulted by a random choice. Most land cover types preferred or avoided are also correlated, weakly, but correlated with woodcock abundance. These correlations were weak. The key element of choice is the presence of forests, but among the forest cover categories, there was no significant differences, which means for me that it is a key element, but nothing else. So the stand of trees is essential, but there is no other specific need. There may be no other specific need, and I will give my opinion about. I will tell you my opinion about that. So woodcock is a migrating species, and in one spring, the individuals take thousands of kilometers within a few days, so in a month. And Hungary is so small in space compared to these dimensions that, yes, woodcocks stop to replenish their fuels for migration in the country, but they don't spend so much time here to have specific needs for the habitat. For example, the needs for a space to raise broods, like in the breeding grounds. As a conclusion, we can say that the higher rate of broadleaf forests near the observations can raise, the higher rate of discontinuous urban fabric and non-irrigated arable land can lower detection probability of woodcock, and these results can support building habitat suitability models for the country during the spring migration, and also supports building population estimation models for the species. And it is also useful information when establishing new observation points.